November 17, 2019, China confirmed the first COVID-19 case in the country. The first outbreak started in Wuhan, Hubei, China. Not so long after, the first cases in Malaysia were confirmed among travelers from China in Johor via Singapore on 25 January 2020.
And several months later.
Dan untuk itu, kerajaan memutuskan untuk melaksanakan perintah kawalan pergerakan mulai 18 Mac 2020 iaitu lusa hingga 31 Mac 2020 di seluruh negara.
Duduk rumah tak boleh keluar, satu aktiviti pun tak ada. Tetapi kesannya adalah kepada bagaimana rakyat kita yang miskin terutamanya nak meneruskan penghidupan mereka. Saya nak maklumkan waktu PKP 1.0 terdapat banyak kes yang melibatkan masalah mental, ya? Tak mental, kes bunuh diri juga banyak berlaku.
Looking at the situation getting worse, the government decided to put everything in a shutdown mode and everyone has to stay inside their home. No one in, no one out, except for the essentials. Since then, everyone's world seems smaller and smaller. The only thing left is me, you, and the world. In fact, I have been discussing with the microwave and the toaster during coffee break, and we all agree that things are getting hard. The unseen battle. COVID-19 virus is not the only thing that cannot be seen with our two eyes, touched by our hands, and smelled by our nose. There is another thing that works like COVID but throw people deeper in a dark side. We are not only in a war with COVID. Indeed, there's an unseen battle in our head. Yes, we are talking about the implications of COVID-19 and the damages this virus has done to us. Violence, divorce, temperament, despair, what else? What else COVID has done to us? What are the reasons for all this?
Suicide, domestic violence, and more to mention. These horrible cases happened due to being locked up in their houses for a long period of time. According to the police, the three major contributors for suicide cases for both men and women are emotional pressure, family problems, and also financial constraints. According to KRI's 2019 Time to Care, gender inequality, unpaid care work, and time use survey, Malaysian women assume more responsibility for unpaid care despite of working the same number of hours as men in paid work, which leads to double burden. Many global studies highlights how domestic work and childcare has increased significantly due to this pandemic. It is women who end up bearing those burdens and often relate to the skewed social structure and gender roles. Not only adults are affected by this situation of pandemic, children are also the victims of this situation. With schools and public spaces closed, children are urged to stay at home and away from their friends and loved ones. They may be trapped in a house with an abuser. This has resulted on children's mental health and well-being. Children are left feeling afraid, lonely, anxious, and feeling hopeless about their future. People might see these problems will end eventually after the restriction bans has lifted. Unfortunately, this only trigger a bigger issue that needs our attention. Relearning and adapting to new roles and new environment is the new challenge for some of us. For some, anxiety and depression seem to only increase the closer we come to the end of lockdown in Malaysia. There is no right or wrong on how some people might feel and how to approach towards these new changes. These changes can bring about a level of stress and anxiety with no certainty on how to live within this short term nor long term. COVID-19 anxiety is real and it does exist. This is due to the occurrence of these horrible cases happened in lockdown. Social anxiety disorder, sometimes called social phobia, is a long-term and overwhelming fear of social situations. It can be very distressing and have a big impact on your mental and physical health. Many of us occasionally get anxious about social interactions. Social anxiety is a fear that does not go away and impacts everyday activities, self-confidence, relationships, and work or school life. Is an intense anxiety triggered before, during, and after social interactions. One study on Malaysians' psychological and mental well-being revealed that 70% of the respondents agreed their anxiety level has increased due to the early phase of lockdown in Malaysia.
Why do we need to heal social anxiety? Social anxiety can significantly interfere with daily activities such as school, work, and relationship. Without treatment, the person may not reach their full potential in school or work. They may avoid group tasks, public speaking, or even receiving a promotion. When social anxiety becomes severe or untreated, the condition can be devastating. Quality of life can be significantly improved with effective intervention, including talking to the therapist, taking medication, or both. Several issues have arisen as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic. We will have to rely on technology to survive the pandemic, whether we like it or not. Artificial intelligence has a bright future in making people who suffer from social anxiety feel more at ease. It is a reasonable response to what's going on and the massive increase in demand for everyone who is feeling the weight of 2020. When we consider the number of people who require mental health care, accessibility and timing is critical. There are several solutions to what we can do to address the problem. Firstly, invent a robot worker. There are many types of robot workers we can invent, such as robot companion, robot server, and also robot mail. Robot companions offers similar benefits to real pets, like non-judgmental companionship, the ability to lessen anxiety, agitation, and to mediate social interaction with other people. While robot server in a restaurant carries food from the kitchen to the dining room, where servers collect the plates and delivers them to the customer's table. The robot can talk to customers more and serve more table. On the other hand, robot mail is electrically powered. It is a self-driving mail truck that will roll out on the street. Its mission is to revolutionize mail and package delivery. Lastly, we create chatbot apps. The chatbot apps are robots or human confederates who serve as counselors who exhibit listening behaviors. Technology has come a long way in a short number of years, and it can help push people past the primary reason they don't reach out for help, which is the stigma and also the fear of being judged. It can help people because it does not have any judgment, and also it is just a software. We do not have to worry whether we are being judged or not. While we are still light years away from a fully robotic workplace, the mechanical skills that many businesses are now utilizing have proven to be one of the most significant innovations of our time. Begin by introducing a few robots and see where it takes you. To sum it up, social anxiety is a mental health condition characterized by a fear of being watched or judged by others in social situations. Many people with this condition do not seek treatment, believing it is just a part of their personality. They may instead seek help for related issues such as depression or substance use. If you ever see someone with social anxiety, please help them. We don't know how it feels, but we surely can be their listener. Be known to yourself for the battles you fight within, the unseen, unheard ones. Be known to yourself for the battles you conquer within. Be yourself for yourself.